So children, you people have seen oxidation and reduction reactions separately. Now we are going to see the reactions in which oxidation and reduction occur simultaneously. Such reactions are called redox reactions. In these reactions, reduction and oxidation occur side by side. We can understand these reactions with the help of certain examples. So the first example is reaction between copper sulfate and zinc to give zinc sulfate and copper. If we write this reaction in one other form, that is we call it as ionic form, in which the ions involved in the reaction are shown. For this we can see copper sulfate means Cu2 plus and SO4 2 minus ion in this compound react with zinc to form Zn2 plus and SO4 2 minus ion as zinc sulfate and copper. So we have written this reaction in ionic form. If you see this ionic form of the reaction, you will come to know that in this reaction Cu2 plus is getting converted to Cu and Zn is getting converted to Zn2 plus. That means Cu2 plus is getting converted to Cu and Zn is getting converted to Zn2 plus. Now how can this happen? This can happen if you suppose you have Cu2 plus and you will remove this positive charge, then only the Cu will be formed. How can you remove this positive charge? If you add two electrons to it, so electrons have negative charge, two electrons having two negative charges will balance the positive charge of copper, and like this copper 2 plus will be converted to copper neutral atom. Here we are doing what? We are adding two electrons to Cu2 plus. So this is addition of electron, and we very well know addition of electron is what? Reduction. In this what is happening? Zn is converted to Zn2 plus. That means how can that happen? That can happen when Zn loses two electrons. By losing two electrons, it will get two positive charges. We see that it is loss of electron. That means it is oxidation. So you can very well see that copper 2 plus ions after gaining electron get converted to copper. So reduction takes place and zinc gets converted to Zn2 plus, so oxidation take place. So here also in this reaction you can see side by side oxidation and reduction reactions are taking place because Cu2 plus converts to Cu and Zn converts to Zn2 plus. You can show this as a single reaction like Cu2 plus plus Zn will form Zn2 plus and Cu. So Cu2 plus to Cu is reduction and Zn to Zn2 plus is oxidation. So this is a redox reaction. Now we can take another example of this. Suppose we have copper oxide and it reacts with hydrogen. It will form copper and water. Here again you see that copper oxide loses oxygen and gets converted to copper. So loss of oxygen is taking place and loss of oxygen is what? Reduction. Now the what is hydrogen doing? Hydrogen is gaining oxygen and getting converted to water. So hydrogen, conversion of hydrogen to water is actually gain of oxygen. By gain of oxygen, hydrogen is converting to water. So this is oxidation. Gain of oxygen is oxidation. So you can see again that in this reaction, copper oxide is reduced to copper, hydrogen is oxidized to water. That means oxidation and reduction reactions are going side by side So it is a redox reaction. Then another example, if you see, example of hydrogen sulfide and chlorine. Hydrogen sulfide and chlorine react to form hydrogen chloride, that is 2HCl and S. Here also, if you see it properly, what happens? If hydrogen from hydrogen sulfide, hydrogen is removed. So hydrogen sulfide after losing hydrogen will convert to sulfur. That is loss of hydrogen. Loss of hydrogen is what? Oxidation. So you can see hydrogen sulfide is getting oxidized to sulfur by loss of hydrogen. And what does chlorine do? Chlorine gains that hydrogen to form HCl. So chlorine, after gaining this hydrogen, gain of hydrogen is taking place, and after gaining the hydrogen, chlorine is getting reduced. So this is conversion of chlorine to hydrogen chloride is reduction. So in this reaction, hydrogen sulfide by losing hydrogen is getting oxidized to sulfur, and chlorine by gaining hydrogen is getting reduced to hydrogen chloride. So side by side, oxidation and reduction reactions are taking place, and this is a redox reaction.